So, good evening.
Good evening, Paul.
Good evening. So, everyone, please open your Bibles to Habakkuk chapter 2. Habakkuk chapter 2. And we will start sa verse 2. Actually, start pala tayo sa verse 1 para mabuo natin yung buong chapter. Okay? So, this is God's word for us tonight. Verse 1. I will take my stand at my watchpost and station myself on the tower and look out to see what he will say to me and what I will answer concerning my complaint. And the Lord answered me, write the vision, make it plain on tablets so he may run who reads it. For still the vision awaits its appointed time. It hastens to the end. It will not lie. If it seems slow, wait for it. It will surely come. It will not delay. Behold, his soul is puffed up. It is not upright with him, but the righteous shall live by his faith. Let's start here muna and let's ask the Lord once again to bless this study. Okay? Father, as we turn to your word right now, we desperately need your help to both to be able to speak and to listen. To pay attention, to believe. You have prepared us by bringing us here tonight. You have prepared your mouthpiece to speak for you. And you have prepared us by providing your word, the Bible, so that we can see and read for ourselves. And so with all that preparation, we now look to you, Lord. We pray that you will meet us and help us understand. For your son's sake, amen. Okay. So, nung iniwan natin to last time, the last scene we saw really was Habakkuk waiting on the Lord on top of this watchtower. Diba? Bakit? Naalala nyo? Kasi hinihintay niya yung sagot sa mga kinukomplain niya. Because by this time, he was so confused, no? He was distressed. Kasi after na inilapit sa Diyos yung mga problema ng bansa niya, after na hiningi yung kanyang intervention dahil nakikita niya na unti-unti na parang mas nagmumukha na silang mga anak ng Satanas kaysa anak ng Diyos, the answer he got was, well, far from what he was expecting. At nung una, ang tagal-tagal pa nga niya sumagot, di ba? Which prompted Habakkuk also to ask, Lord, how long are you gonna make me wait? Lord, nandiyan ka pa ba? Lord, naririnig mo ba talaga itong mga pinagpe-pray ko? Pero nung sumagot naman yung Panginoon, well, let's just say na, well, actually, pinangunahan pa nga siya ni God sa verse 5 ng chapter 1. Na look among the nations and see, wonder and be astounded. For I am doing work in your days that you would not believe if told. Kasi nga di makapaniwala si Habakkuk sa nakuha niyang sagot. Because instead of a revival, God shows him that he was about to severely punish them through this Babylonian invasion. Through this evil, evil nation. Specifically raised by him to destroy their city because of their disobedience. And so here's Habakkuk, this man of God, this prophet, reeling from the revelation that he just received. And he's like, God, you don't make sense anymore. Kasi how can you use an evil person, people like them, to punish a less evil people like us? And because this is all part of your divine plan, alam ko din walang makakapigil na sa kanila. So this evil and this tyranny will just go on until forever. And so as we open tonight, we see Habakkuk at this place of anguish. No? He's still trusting in God, pero umiiyak na rin siya. Sabi niya, Lord, tulungan mo naman ako rito. Help me understand what's going on. Kasi gulong-gulo na ako. And as we have seen so far dito sa libro ni Habakkuk, whenever his people prays, God will respond. No? He will answer. Pero sa timeline lang, sa timeline lang nga niya, hindi at hindi sa kung kailan natin siya gustong sumagot. Okay? And let me also tell you this while on, we are on this topic. Because he is God, he is actually far more aware of the evil that's going on around us, more so than we usually give him credit for. Alam niyo ba yun? So kung ang inaalala mo ay kung nakikita ba niya o naintindihan ba niya, he knows. Okay? He knows. Actually nga, not only does he know every detail of it, pero alam na niya kung saan patungo to at ano ang pinaka-ending ng lahat na to. Diyos eh. And so the question really is us. Di ba? How do we respond to this? How do we respond when we know in our hearts that He should fix all this evil, pero ang bagal-bagal niya? At lalo na yan, if things are very quickly going from bad to worse. Tapos yung di siya sumasagot, ang hirap nun, di ba? So what do we do when God doesn't act according to our timetable, but according to His? I mean, totoo naman, as Christians, we do know that He's going to act. We know that He's gonna right every wrong. We know that He's gonna punish every traitor and every cheater and every liar. We know He's going to do all of that. Kasi yan naman ang sinabi sa atin sa Bible. Pero the thing is, hindi natin alam kung kailan. Tama? At ewan ko kung napansin nyo din to. Pero hindi ba ganun lagi si God? He keeps telling us that he's going to do this in this word. Pero hindi naman niya sasabihin sa atin kung kailan. Even si Jesus himself. Sabi niya, one day in the future, I will come back for you. Pero as we go, hey, excited na ako. Teka, kailan ulit yan? Only the Father who knows when. Kita na yun? I mean, minsan parang nakakainis, di ba? But have you ever wondered why He does that? I mean, why does God do that? Gagawin ko ito, 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 pero hindi ko sasabihin sa'yo kung kailan. Alam niyo kung bakit? Well, we'll see later more clearly sa verse 4. Pero for us to grasp the bigger picture, mag-umpisa muna tayo dito sa verse 2. Okay? Kasi while Habakkuk was patiently waiting on this watchtower kung saan natin siya iniwan in the last time, God actually came to give him his answer. No? At ito sabi niya, write the vision. Make it plain on tablets. Now, these words right here is actually very critical for us to fully understand the rest of this book. Bakit? Well, kasi tingnan niyo how this passage starts. And the Lord answered me. At yung Lord dito is actually a translation of God's covenant name, Yahweh. No? It's this promise giving, faithful to His word, faithful to the people that He loves, God, who graciously responds to Habakkuk's complaint here. And because of that, this response is going to be super duper important. Paano kung nasabi yun? Well, tingnan mo kung ano yung sinabi na next. Write the vision. Write this down. Just make a record of this and make sure that it is so clear and so legible enough na kahit sino pang makabasa nito ay makakaintindi. Why? Because when all of these things that I will tell you come to pass, ito na yung magiging resibo nyo na hindi ako nagsisinungaling. Na meron talagang Diyos at gagawin ko lahat ng sinabi ko ang gagawin ko mula sa umpisa hanggat sa huli. And notice how the verse also ends. So he may run who reads it. And the idea of this, the idea of running with God's word simply means to proclaim it or to spread it to every person everywhere. Hanggat lahat ng tao dyan sa lugar nyo ay makakarinig nitong vision na gusto kong iparating sa inyo. At anong vision yan? Ano yung vision na yan? Well, it's found in verses 4 to 20, wherein i-explain ni God kay Habakkuk na yes, oo nga, i-discipline ako kayo through this Babylonian army that is coming. Pero make no mistake about it. These people will also pay for their destruction and the evil that they will cause. So hindi sila absuelto dito. They will pay. And so ang tanong na lang dito is how you should respond, Habakkuk, after I show you all of this. How? Actually, simple lang yung sagot. You are now just to trust me. Because verse 3, the vision awaits its appointed time. So although pinapakita ko na sa iyo ito ngayon, none of this is going to happen right away. Matagal-tagal pa to. Pero know that it is on schedule. There's this appointed time for it. Which may basically means na kapag may binitawang salita ang Diyos, huwag mo na siyang poproblemahin. Kasi as sure as the sun is rising in the morning, mangyayari at mangyayari yan. It's not going to be fulfilled a day before or a day after. It's going to happen exactly as the Lord planned it. At ano ang encouragement sa atin nito? The encouragement is that He is actually working all things to fulfill this plan. No? Yan actually ang ibig sabihin ng it hastens to the end. Kasi there's this drive, this impulse for God to accomplish His will kahit ano pang mangyari. Kaya nga din niya sinabing it will not lie. Ibig sabihin, hindi ko sasabihin sa iyo lahat to tapos hindi ko gagawin. Hindi ako ganun. So if it seems slow, it only seems to be slow. Kaya just wait for it. Bakit? Well, ano ba sinabi na next? Because it might come, ba? Hindi, di ba? Because it will surely come. So God's will in this world and in your life will certainly and undoubtedly be done. It will not even delay. It will not even hesitate. Kaya friends, Christian, if you know God's word and you understand His promises in the right context, know that it is coming. No? Nothing in the universe can stop it. It will come. At anong ibig sabihin na ito specifically para kay Habakkuk sa mga kinocomplain niya? Well, God will indeed use the Babylonians to discipline His people. Yan naman yung malinaw na malinaw since chapter 1. Pero hindi niya hahayaan lang to. Kasi yun nga, pagkatapos niyan, He will also punish these same Babylonians for doing all these evil things to His people. And all of these things will take place at the exact time and in the exact way that God has set it out to happen. And so as we take a step back from these words na binabasa natin dito, as we ponder on our struggles and our own worries kung bakit ang tagal-tagal niyang sumagot sa mga inilalapit natin sa Kanya, the first thing that we all need to understand here is what Habakkuk is also starting to learn, no? Na ano? The God is always working based on His own timetable and not ours. Okay? At i-expect na natin yan kasi kung di mahihirapan talaga tayo. Because what submitting actually means is that you are putting yourself under God's authority as you wait for Him to do His work. In other words, you are letting God be God instead of you trying to be God for Him. Kasi magpakatotoo na tayo, we all make horrible gods compared to Him. Agree ba? And so as we take comfort and rejoice on His promises, as we hear that He will right every wrong and He will wipe every tear away from our eyes, we do, however, have to be patient. We have to be patient as God acts as He sees fit and not when we see fit. Kasi tandaan niyo, this is also an evidence of God's Spirit living inside of you as He's molding you and shaping you into the image of Christ tulad ng nang ipinakita sa atin sa Galatians. In fact, sa Colossians, this was even stated as a command. Alam niyo ba yon? To all the impatient Christians. Kasi yung put on dito means go. Umpisahan mo na, start being patient now. Pero ito din yun. Kasi it's one thing to call Christians to be patient with the difficult people in our lives. Nahabaan mo yung PC mo sa mga masasama o sa mga ignorante o sa selfish or whatever. Pero it's an entirely different thing to call being patient with God, who is not any of these things. Tama ba? Because being patient with God simply means to submit to His will. To say, thy will be done, instead of demanding my will to be done. Pero that's what we do sometimes. Di ba? Yung nga ginagawa ni Habakuk dito as he sees evil and injustice rising everywhere. At tayo din, as we see senseless killings and scammers and false religions abound. As we see even in our own lives, the emotional pain and the bodily sickness that afflicts us. Minsan talagang mapapatanong tayo, Lord! Lord, ano ba to? How much more of this suffering do I have to endure before you do something and stop this? Now, as Bible-believing Christians, sabi ko nga kanina, we know that one day God will act and will end all of it naman. We know that. Kaya nga tayo umiyak at tumatakbo sa Kanya. However, it's in the mindset na mas alam pa natin sa Kanya kung kailan siya dapat gumalaw, that's where we go wrong. No? Kasi just because we don't know the when doesn't mean that the when should be now. Agree ba? It just cannot possibly work that way. Because we never have the whole picture. We never have everything figured out. Sometimes we cannot even pinpoint the end from the beginning. So when things seem delayed, when things seem off schedule, when your mind starts to wonder kung natutulog ba ang Diyos, the answer is and will always be no. No? So be patient. Kasi when God says that He will do something, hindi naman yan nakasalalay na sa'yo. It's all going to be up to Him to make it happen. Kaya let's all quit the second guessing, pwede ba? Let's all quit the questions and the doubts that will do nothing but produce even more anxiety within us. So what am I saying? I'm saying just relax a little bit. Relax lang. Pero natutunaw na yung mundo ko. Even so, bakit? Because God knows what He's doing. Listen, guys, if your requests are in line with His word, He will bring it to pass. Okay? Promise niya sa atin yan. And that's a pillow that you can rest on tonight. So let's just wait. Let's be patient as He works His timetables towards that appointed time that He has already laid out for your life and my life. Instead of putting our hope in some human timetable or some idea na of what we think should happen and when it should happen. Kasi kaya nga sinasabi ni God kay Habakuk dito na, just put all your hope in me. Now, let's look at verse 4. Behold, his soul is puffed up. It is not upright with him, but the righteous shall live by his faith. And this actually makes it all very clear, no? Kasi the reality is that there are only two responses that any one of us can make to God. One is arrogance, and the other, acceptance. At yun lang. And this is true even for the people from the Old Testament, no? Where we have people like Habakkuk and Job and Moses and Abraham who, although they did not fully understand what God was really doing, naniwala pa rin sila. They accepted God's word as it was given to them. And the opposite of that is also being described here to us. Sabi, the other soul is puffed up. Meaning these people are so bloated with pride because of this tumor that is growing inside them called self. And these are the people who says, yes, okay, pero that's only what God says. Ako, I have my own special thing going on. Kaya kong diskartehan to. So bakit pa ako bakit ko pa kailangan maghintay when I can do things by my own self and by my own understanding? And friends, I hope hindi ikaw to, no? Kasi this is the exact kind of person who is not right with God. Sabi dito, he's not even upright. Dahil baluktot ang pag-iisip niya compared to God's standards. And so ano ba dapat? Ano ba dapat? Notice, but the righteous shall live by his faith. The righteous, meaning those people who are safe from God's wrath and will therefore live, they are doing what's right in God's eyes simply because they keep trusting in him. They keep trusting in him, even though there's invasion and deportation and destruction and slavery all in their immediate future. Pero the people who's doing what's right in this situation, sabi ng Panginoon, are the people who trust in me anyway. Regardless kung ano pa ang mangyari. Kaya itong verse na to, itong verse 4, this is like the ultimate text that holds the entire Bible together. No? It's the central theme of all of Scripture. Some people would even say that this is the greatest verse in all of the Bible. Because it started a whole revolution that's been spreading all around the world since Genesis until this very day. Why? Because that's how we're saved. That is what saved Abraham. Naalala niyo? God promised him a son. Hindi na sinabi kung kailan, but he promised him that a son would come. And Abraham has to wait for over a decade for it to come to pass, just clinging on to this promise. Kaya sabi sa Genesis 15:6 na, and Abraham believed the Lord and he counted to him as righteousness. This is also what saved Habakkuk here. Kasi alam ba niya kung kailan dadating yung disiplina na sinasabi ng Panginoon? Hindi. Alam ba niya kung kailan din mapaparusahan itong mga Babylonians dahil sa mga pinaggagawa nila? Mas lalong hindi. So what was he supposed to do? Trust God anyways. Friends, this is what marks those who are right with God. They trust in him regardless. Kaya when the Apostle Paul quoted Habakkuk 2:4 in both Galatians and Romans as proof texts, ang pinakapunto niya dito is that even in the Old Testament, salvation and safety from God's wrath, in other words, being declared right with God, is and will always be received by faith alone. At parang siya nakarating sa conclusion na yan? Well, first, this word na righteous. Ano ba ibig sabihin nito? Kasi hindi ito simpleng mabait o matuwid lang. Okay? So ano? Well, what this is it's a important legal term that refers to the decision of a judge na kailangan gumitna between a defendant and the law. No? And as he's listening to this defendant, as he's comparing this defendant's life to what the law says, titingnan na yan kung magmamatch sila. Kung match sila, if his life conforms to the standard without any deviations, then he's going to be declared righteous. Pero kung hindi, if he finds any kind of sin in there, like he's definitely going to find in your life and in my life, ano mangyayari? We're all going to be declared guilty. Hence our dilemma. So ang tanong talaga dito is how can unrighteous people like us be declared right when God knows full well that we aren't right? Di ba? When he compares our lives to what the law says. Well, unfortunately, the answer that most people give to that question is, teka lang, teka lang. Naman akong tao. Alam ko marami akong nagawang mali, pero di hamak naman na mas marami akong nagawang mabuti. So don't these things just sort of cancel each other out? Kasi ang dami ko ng ipon, no? And I hope ma-appreciate ng Panginoon to. I hope He's gonna let me in because of these good things that I've done. Pero isn't this really just a disguise for arrogance? For self-reliance? For self-sufficiency? Yung tipong, I've done my best and I'll continue to do my best to be righteous enough, to do what needs to be done, to be worthy of His grace. Pero it's the complete opposite of verse 4. Diba? Kasi ano ulit ang sabi dito? But the righteous shall live by his faith. Now, itong faith, ano naman to? Well, ano ba ibig sabihin pag sinabi mong may faith ka sa asawa mo? It means that you have a solid and strong commitment. Diba? Hindi naman ibig sabihin yan na ina-acknowledge mo lang na mag-asawa kayo. So in a way, ganun din to, no? Faith is to be fully devoted to trusting in Jesus as not only your Savior, but also your Lord. And this is not just it's not me saying na, okay, naniniwala naman ako na may Diyos, o naniniwala naman ako na namatay siya at nabuhay ulit. Yes, tama naman yan. But it's not just that. Kasi faith is trust. It's giving yourself to Jesus. It's your life and your death and your everything to Him and to Him alone. Faith is saying that if there is heaven, then patay na ako. Kasi all my hope is in you and in you alone. Ito na yun. There's not even a hint of self-sufficiency. I'm stripped of all pride. Because I bring nothing to the table except my dirty, dirty life that I fully surrender to you. At sabihin ko na sa inyo ngayon, when God sees that, and then He sees your life of sin, and then by His grace, He will declare you righteous, not based upon your record, but based upon His record of perfect obedience, of perfect righteousness imputed into your account. Kaya what this verse 4 really is a life rescued from God's wrath. No? It's safety from the penalty that we all deserve for our sin. So although ang context nitong Habakkuk, what this is actually referring to is this remnant of people who trust God to one day save them even even as they are being captured and dragged into Babylon. Itong idea na to, this idea goes beyond just the physical. This is spiritual. This is eternal life in heaven with Christ forever. At tayo today, we demonstrate this relationship by faith. Diba? We receive eternal life by faith. So natural lang that we continue living the Christian life by faith also. Trusting in God. From the very beginning of our spiritual lives, all the way to the end of our physical lives. Now, bakit pala physical life? Because faith ends at death. Alam niyo ba yun? Why? Because one day, faith will give way to sight. Meaning you won't need faith anymore kasi as you will see Him as He is. And that is what a true Christian longs for, no? To be with His Savior. Kaya tulad ni Jesus doon sa garden, we embrace And by the way, iyan pala ibig sabihin ng pangalan ni Habakuk, okay? To embrace. Because we trust in a God who always does right. So regardless of my feelings, regardless of my circumstances, even when I do not understand the future, excuse me, kung ano man yan, I just say, Lord, come what may, I will trust in you and embrace whatever it is that you bring into my life. Ngayon, speaking of that, kung natandaan niyo, meron pang tanong si Habakuk na hindi pa nasasagot. Di ba? Sabi na, Lord, bakit naman ganito? How can you use an evil and wicked nation like Babylon to discipline your people who are less wicked? Tsaka kung ikaw din pala ang nagplano nito, eh di ibig sabihin, wala na talagang kaming pag-asa. Well, starting dito sa verse 5, God graciously gives his answer to this. No? He didn't have to answer when he did, but somehow he did. At tingnan mo sinasabi niya. Moreover, wine is a traitor. An arrogant man who is never at rest. His greed is as white as Sheol. Like death, he has never enough. He gathers for himself all nations. He collects as his own, all peoples. So basically, ang sinasabi na dito is, Habakuk, alam ko. Okay? Huwag mong iisipin na wala akong pake dito. I see all of this and I know. At ito yung proof. Kaya dinescribe na yung Babylonians dito para sa kanya. Sabi niya, wine is a traitor. An arrogant man who is never at rest. And the idea is here is tulad ng alak, these Babylonians were intoxicated with pride. Hindi na sila nakontento sa pangharas nila sa mga ibang bansa. In fact, they became so greedy na kinumpara sila sa Sheol or death, sa kamatayan. And that's because death never takes a vacation. Di ba? Kasi kahit anong klaseng panahon pa yan, di mo awala sa uso yung kamatayan. It just insatiably swallows everything in its path, gathering for himself as many people as possible. And what the Lord is working towards here is itong mga taong to, may hangganan din sila. They will have their day. Kasi look at verse 6. Shall not all these take up their taunt against him with scoffing and riddles for him? Now, sinong yung all this dito? Yung mga biniktima nila. These people who were mistreated and conquered and caused to suffer by the hands of Babylon. At ano yung ginawa nila? They will take up their taunt against him. Pagtatawanan at panglalaitan nila sila. So itong verse 6 hanggang 20 is basically a mockery of these Babylonians, no? Dahil sa mangyayari sa kanila. Bakit? Kasi God is about to make a very object lesson out of them. And that's why this next section also serves as a warning for all the future tyrants and oppressors. For these people who takes joy in victimizing other people because they clearly have no respect for God and their fellow human beings. And to show us how serious he is about all of this, God will give us these 5 statements that all begins with this word, Nawo. Nawo is a cry of mourning. Usually, ginagamit yan sa mga lamay. Di ba? Jesus also used this on the Pharisees, no, sa New Testament for their hypocrisy. So in essence, these are curses that will be pronounced by God on the Babylonians dahil dyan sa mga pinagkagagawa nila. Kaya if you today are in a person of authority, mapabansa ba yan, o negosyo, o even sa sariling pamilya mo, God is saying that if you act like how the Babylonians did, dahil sa position mo sa buhay, you might get away with it for a while. Pero in reality, you're as good as dead. Kasi there will be a reversal of fortune. You will reap what you sow. How you treat other people will be how you are treated. At wala kang takas dyan. It will come. But what is all of this saying to us ultimately? Well, as we again take a step back from what we are reading here and think about this sa sarili nating mga buhay, sa sarili nating mga hinaharap na problema, yung mga injustices and in persecutions, when God delays, when He doesn't answer our prayers to end the evil and to establish peace and justice and truth in all the world, when it seems na parang natutulog nga siya, when all of these evil men go from bad to worse, what we must all realize here is that it will all surely come. No. Justice will come. And this book is so clear pagdating dito. Nandi lang sa nakikita na yung mga nangyayari, but He is going to address all of it. Every single sin. And He's going to deal with it so thoroughly that everybody who looks at His judgment will go, this is good. This is right. This is fair. And so, tingnan natin. To begin, tingnan natin to beginning with verse 6. Because justice is coming for these five acts of sins. These five acts that each of us will also have to watch out for. Starting with this first one. Greed or extortion. Sabi dito, woe to him who heaps up what is not his own. Anong tawag mo doon? Pagnanakaw. Diba? For how long? And loads himself with pledges. Will not your debtors suddenly arise and those awake who will make you tremble? Why? Kasi gusto nilang makuha lahat ng mga ninakaw mo sa kanila. Then you will be spoiled for them. Because you have plundered many nations. All the remnants of the people shall plunder you for the blood of men and violence to the earth, to cities and all who dwell in them. So in other words, the day will come when Babylon's enemies will reclaim what is rightfully theirs. So lahat ng kinuha nila, lahat ng ninakaw nila, all the spoils of war that were stolen will be taken back by their victims when the Babylonians are finally defeated. Okay, in the end, the oppressor will be the one oppressed. Now, a second justice is coming, this time naman for evil gain. Verse 9, woe to him who gets evil gain for his house, meaning his building this empire by accumulating all this wealth through evil means, to set his nest on high, to be safe from the reach of harm. Kasi sa dami ng perang ninakaw mo, you have built up these walls to protect you from any backlash. Pero by doing that, you have devised shame for your house. By cutting off many peoples, you have forfeited your life. For the stone will cry out from the wall and the beam from the woodwork respond. Nakikita niyo yung sinasabi dito? Because Babylon made their fortune through evil and malicious ways. Kala nila protektado na sila. They thought that just because they now live in this glorious and rich and safe mansion, that their dynasty will be long-lasting. Pero for trampling on many nations to reach that point of humiliation will actually be their future. So yes, they have gained the world for a while. Pero by doing that, they have actually forfeited their souls. At itong verse 11 is particularly very powerful, no? Kasi there's this picture of stones and beams. And the idea here is that when Babylon comes, isisira nila yung mga building sa Judah. At kukunin nila yung mga biga at mga kahoy to build their own buildings out of it. Pero dahil ganyan ang ginawa mo, God says, That stone that you took and put into your own wall, that stone will be screaming at you about the evil that you did in that city. As that house of yours begin to fill with the cries of your guilt, of your guilt, as that empire of yours rises up, it will immediately collapse on itself because it was never yours to begin with. And this was fulfilled, no? Kasi Babylon, as we shall see in our history books, it would end in utter ruin. Now, this next justice that's coming, and it's for exploitation. Exploitation. Look at verse 12. Woe to him who builds a town with blood and founds a city on iniquity. Behold, it is not from the Lord of hosts that people labor merely for fire and nations weary themselves for nothing. So ano ibig sabihin nito? Well, God is saying that even while in the process of building up their cities, they have already sealed their fate. Why? Because they have built it with brutality. Because they built it with these abused slaves who were treated like animals. Meaning they just worked them and worked them hanggat di na sila makatayo. Para saan? So that when visitors come into their city, mapapawaw sila. At totoo naman yun, no? During this time, every single person would have been in awe of the beauty and the magnificence of Babylon. That is every person except God. Kasi when God sees Babylon, all he sees are these victims. And he's enraged at the violence and the injustice that is being perpetrated there. Kaya he's going to turn everything on his head. Tingnan niyo yung sinabi na sa verse 13. It's merely for fire. It's all going up in smoke. Everything these Babylonians wanted, everything they thought was permanent and substantial, will burn. At sino ang gagawa niyan? Ikaw ba? Ako? Hindi. It's the Lord of hosts. God is the one who will destroy them, and because of that, they will have no hope of stopping it. Kaya nga, no wicked kingdom in this world will last, no? For the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God as the waters covers the sea. Kasi there will be no room for them. In fact, there will not be room for anything other than the kingdom of God one day. Alam niyo ba yun? Kaya all those who opposes him right now, all those who brutalizes and victimizes their neighbor so that they can become the richest or the biggest, it will all be destroyed. And so for the tyrants of our time, for the kings and the presidents and the mayors and the bosses and the CEOs who are taking advantage of their limited authority over the people, God is going to destroy them one day as he extends his reign over the whole world. At pwede nating asahan yan because this is a promise and a reality that is not just for Habakkuk and his people, but for us as well. So let's all just trust God and his timetable. Pwede ba? Let's all be calm as we face change in persecutions in our lifetimes. Kasi even if we do not know if we live or die because of this, we are the Lord's. Amen? God's unstoppable kingdom is coming. It's coming. At bilang Kristiyano, guess what? Going to be able to see it with your own eyes. You're going to be there. Kaya tonight, if you truly believe this, if you truly believe God's word, then grab hold of this truth and bring it to your troubles and let that be the way that you view what is going on in your life from this day forward. Okay? Now, meron pa. Let's look at the fourth justice or the fourth or the for the fourth sin. And this is enticing other people to sin. Enticing others to sin. Tingnan niyo yung verse 15. Woe to him who makes his neighbors drink. You pour out your wrath and make them drunk in order to gaze at their nakedness. You will have to your fill of shame instead of glory. Drink yourself and show your uncircumcision. The cup in the Lord's right hand will come around you and utter shame will come upon your glory. And that is because Babylon has abused his power to compel others to sin. No? Yung mga hinuli nila, yung mga slaves nila, they made them degrade themselves as they use them for their own entertainment. And what the Lord is saying here is that as you do that, know that the Lord's hand will come around you. Meaning as you treat others with shame and humiliation, this very same thing will be poured upon you. In fact, mas malala pa nga kasi look at verse 17. The violence done to Lebanon will overwhelm you, as will the destruction of the beast that terrified them. In short, you're gonna be destroyed. Why? For the blood of men and violence to the earth, to cities and all who dwell in them. Kasi tulad ng mga hayop na minasakar nyo as you feed the expansion of your kingdom, so is God of the universe coming for you. And all of this is because they have put their hope on their own emptiness. All these worldly riches and power that so many people today crave, even today, especially today, it's all emptiness. By the way, the Hebrew word for emptiness is also the word that they use for idol. Alam niyo ba yon? Meaning it's not real. It's nothing. That's why idolatry is like the worst sin, no? And look what the Lord says about this in verse 18 and 19. What profit is an idol when its maker has shaped it? A metal image, a teacher of lies? For its maker trusts in his own creation when he makes speechless idols. Woe to him who says to a wooden thing, awake to a silent stone, arise. Can this teach? Behold, it is overlaid with gold and silver, and there is no breath at all in it. So this so-called God they trusted in, these gods that they sacrificed to and prayed to and did all these rituals in honor of, all of these gods will prove to be empty in the end. Kasi kahit anong sigaw at iyak mo dyan sa mga yan, as you see destruction coming towards you, they're not gonna do anything. They're just not. They don't have any power. They can't teach. They can't arise. They can't even help themselves. So all they seem are these supernatural beings, but in reality, they are nothing. They're nothing. And nothing can do anything, tama ba? They can't guide you. They can't help you. So all their promises are nothing but lies. Kasi nga, an idol is not alive at all. It's just a piece of wood or stone or metal or kung ano pa yan. But the Lord, in contrast to these idols and counterfeit gods, the reality is that the Lord is in His holy temple. Amen? He's right now on his temple in heaven. And most importantly, he's alive and uncreated. Kaya he gets to speak and do what he wants when he wants. Pero itong Babylon, they still ignored him, no? And so we see that specifically sa Daniel chapter 5. Basahin nyo na lang yan mamaya kung may oras kayo. But you'll see that eventually they'll have proof that God was really the one who is behind all the victory and all the greatness that they had. Pero kahit pa ganun, they still choose to ignore him. In fact, they even dishonored him and blasphemed him after knowing that. Kaya the Lord ended this revelation that he's showing Habakkuk here with this. Let all the earth keep silence before him. And the vision ends in silence. In silence. Para alam nilang, silence in the Bible is a prelude to judgment. No? So the idea here is that the verdict has been given and punishment is indeed coming. And as we reach that point, nobody can do anything about it but just to stand back with their mouth shut and with one collective thought. Oh no. So when God's work seems to be delayed, when he's not following the timetable that we think he should be following, when we think things should be happening in this way or that way instead of his way, sometimes the best thing for us to do really is to just shut up. No more questions. No more protesting. No more God, ano ba to? O Lord, ba't ang tagal-tagal mo namang sumagot? Lord, naiinip na ako dito. No! What you and I need to do is to put your hand over your mouths and just be quiet. As an act of trust and submission na, Lord, alam mo yung ginagawa mo rito. Kaya maski na hindi ko naiintindihan kahit konti, kahit katiting, I'll be quiet about this now simply because I trust in you. So as we, for the last time, well at least for tonight, as we for the last time take a step back from these verses and these events that happened over 2,500 years ago. What is all of this really telling us? Well, for one, whether in your own individual capacity or in a more corporate capacity, for all the kingdoms of the world, so to speak, if you treat people in a similar way, if you extort money from them, if you steal and plunder their assets, if you build your empire through taking advantage of others, if you treat fellow human beings like animals to make you feel good about yourselves, if you entice other people to sin and rebel against God, if you're trying to fulfill the will of false gods, whether it's a false idols of the religions of this world, or even the more deceptive idol of self. Kung ginagawa mo lahat yan, or even just any one of these things, instead of worshiping the one and true living God, just know that justice is coming for you too. Let this be a warning for all of us. Kasi tandaan nyo, itong Babylon, it's not an isolated incident, but it's actually a picture. A picture that God wants to show all of us who might be living in one or more of these sins, whether it is now or papunta pa lang tayo dun. It is telling each and every one of us to evaluate our own hearts and say, I better not go that way. Nakita ko na yung consequences at wag na lang. Kasi if I go that way, that same fate that happened to Babylon will happen to me. So yes, sometimes it might seem like justice is far, far away. Minsan parang natutulog na ang Diyos. Pero for all who think that way, for all who thinks that they have gotten away with it, to all the future tyrants and the false rulers and the petty dictators, alam niyo, yung mga tao sa buhay niyo o sa trabaho niyo o ikaw mismo, if you continue treating other people like slaves, like they're not human beings or image bearers of God, one day justice will be breathing down your neck too. And the only hope that you and I have is to repent. Is to repent. Remember, God graciously sent Jonah to Nineveh to warn a wicked people who is essentially like these Babylonians. Pero anong ginawa nila when they heard this word? They repented. They turned from their ways and God relented from this disaster that was coming towards them. And so we know that God is patient, no? He's not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But know also that his patience has a limit. It will run out. So please lang, huwag niyong lolokohin yung sarili niyo. Huwag kang matutuwa kung wala pang nangyayari sa'yo. But rather turn and turn quickly from your rebellion before any of these things happen. Beg him for mercy from your wickedness. And maybe, just maybe, God will relent like with the Ninevites. But whatever happens, don't ever, ever be like these Babylonians. Alam niyo yun? Yung alam na nila yung totoo at tama, pero rumebelde pa rin. At ano yung nangyari sa kanila? Well, justice did come. Paano? Well, again, bukod sa Bible, it's in our history books. Actually, hindi lang nga doon. Subukan mo lang mag-research ng Babylon sa Google Maps ngayon. Try nyo. Pero ano yung makikita mo doon? Wala. It's a whole lot of nothing. It's just sand and ruins today. Kasi nga, Babylon as an empire, as this world superpower na kinatatakutan ng lahat, they lasted only about 70 or 80 years. Isang henerasyon lang ang tinagal nila. And this is because everything that God said would happen to them, happened. Every detail na kakabasa lang natin yan, it happened exactly as God said it would. Because these nations that they have previously oppressed, these nations like the Medes and the Persians, they all rose up in power and defeated them so thoroughly na lahat ng ninakaw nila, all this ill-gotten wealth that they have accumulated, they all just went back, right back to the people. To their victims, tulad nitong mga Hudyo. Kasi the Persians who conquered Babylon gave what was lost back to them. No? Ipinondohan pa nga nila yung pag-rebuild ng bayan nila, including God's temple, which was also destroyed. Using what? Using the exact same resources that the Babylonians had taken. Which is crazy. Diba? Parang naka-choreograph lahat, pero totoong buhay siya. Every single thing. And again, how did we know that this would all happen? Because God said so. Pero alam niyo tayo, even when we know this. Ano pa din ang madalas ang tendency natin? Ano? Well, instead of owning up to it, nao nga, no? Ako to. Kaya kailangan ko humingi ng kapatawaran sa Panginoon. Imbis na ganun, ginagawan pa natin ng excuse. Di ba? Sinasabi natin, eh, ang dami-dami ko nang nagawa, wala naman siyang imik. So wala yan. Okay lang yan. Or, yes, God may have done this during the biblical times, pero hindi na siya ganun ngayon. He's now so loving and so forgiving that I don't have to worry about any of this justice thing anymore. Or lumaki naman akong Kristiyano. At yung buong pamilya ko Kristiyano, o yung anak ko naman ay pastor, o ako mismo pastor. So I'm good. I'm a good person. No, you're not. No, you're not. Kasi without Christ, the truth is you are hanging over the pit of hell in every second of every day that you're living in this life. So it's only an illusion that you are safe, no? Kasi ang totoo niyan is you are in the worst possible danger. It may be 5 years that He gives you or 50 years. Hindi natin alam. But every single second of that time that you have, you are already hanging by a single thread that is dangling over eternal justice. It is only by the sheer mercy and kindness of God that is keeping you from totally falling to hell under the weight of your own sin and staying there forever. Grabe naman yan, Paul. Ano to? Tinatakot mo ba kami? Yes! But I'm scaring you with the truth. And this chapter of Habakkuk confirms it, no? That justice is indeed coming for the unrighteous. At kung hindi pa din nagre-register sa inyo kung sino ba talaga yung unrighteous na yan, at kailangan ko pang i-spell out sa inyo, it's you. Okay? It's not that person that you're thinking of. Yes, it's him or her also. Pero ang kailangan mo talaga problemahin ngayon is that it's really you and me who are like these Babylonians. It's you and me who are stealing from other people. It's you and me who are enticing other people to sin, who are exploiting them and using them to build ourselves up. It's you and me who at times turn from the one true God to trust in these false made-up gods. Diba? Kaya when we read here that justice is coming, that good and fair and righteous justice is coming, huwag ka sobrang matuwa kasi that justice also coming for you too. And yet, Jesus steps in between us. No? Jesus takes the bullet of God's justice, which by the way has been correctly and rightly and justly aimed at your heart. But He takes it. He takes it. And that's good news, tama? Actually, that's the best possible news, that God would punish Jesus for your sins and my sins. And that by faith, by trusting in Jesus and Jesus alone, you would receive His righteousness. Para pag nakasalang ka na sa korte ng Panginoon, when your court case comes before God, the only thing na pwede na lang niyang sabihin is case thrown out for lack of evidence. Not guilty. Bakit? Because your life at that point and God's law perfectly matches. Wala nang dumi kahit konti. It's not because of your resume, no? But it's because of His resume. Pero yung your greatest obstacle to experiencing all of this is what? It's your pride. Diba? Yung ilusyon mo na kaya mo to. That you can do a lot of things to be right with God. Na ang pinag-usapan lang natin dito are these Babylonians and these really, really bad people na nasa isip mo. Pero ito kasi ang problema dun. Kung posible yon. If you can, by the good things, make yourself right with Him, then Jesus died for nothing. Tama? Why does He have to suffer and take the weight of all your sins kung pwede mo naman palang ikaw na lang? And the answer is because you can. In fact, wala kang may offer para makabayad ng kahit isang kasalanan mo, much less all of your sins. Kaya Jesus paid it all. No? That's why he did not leave a single thing behind para saluhin mo. He did all 100% for you to be right with God. And what you and I need to do is to put all your hope and all your trust in that single act of sacrifice. Put all your trust in Him and in Him alone. And you do it now. You do it now. Huwag mo nang patagalin. Do not wait. Kasi hindi mo alam kung gaano pa katagal lang meron ka. Kung kailangan mo pa ng clarification, there's pastors here in this room. And even me. Please talk to me after this kung kailangan. Pero do it now. Okay? Do it now. Let's close in prayer. Father, there's just so much more to say about this. Nampas isang oras na kami dito, but we, in reality, we have just touched the surface of the richness of your word. Thank you, Lord, that we are now beginning to understand what you are trying to say to us. That you, Lord, is a God who is constantly perfect. You are perfectly righteous and you are perfectly just. It's to simply know that, to simply have that knowledge, that thought alone is enough to put steel in our spines and conviction in our hearts. Now we can indeed live faithfully to you, no matter what kind of darkness or injustice na pumasok sa buhay namin. And speaking of darkness, I want to specifically pray also tonight for all of us, all of those here who have not yet trusted in Christ. Yes. Yes, Lord, you know that, and we know, Lord, that life is hard. Life is messy. But may these people, may they never miss the point that in spite of all of this, that you are still rescuing people from a fate that is worse than the destruction of a nation. And that is the destruction of a soul. So I pray, Lord, for every unbelieving heart here to trust in Jesus and Jesus alone for their salvation from your wrath. That when Jesus says, "Come to me, all ye who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." And that whoever comes to me, I will never cast out. That they would really actually take this to heart and not turn their backs on it. So that when all of it, all of this is all, when all is said and done, we will all be together. Lahat kami rito. But we will all take part in that messianic banquet that is to come. As we all fully praise you forever and ever for your sovereign grace. So we'll pray and lift all of this up to you. Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.